On the matter of
Senate Blue Ribbon Committee Chairman Richard Gordon taps the Anti-Money Laundering Council to scrutinize the financial records of formerly pharmaceutical corporation. The controversial company that bagged the government's more than 8 billion peso worth of contracts for pandemic supplies. Gordon wants the AMLAC to find out how a company with a 600,000 peso capital by the end of 2019 was able to supply 2.4 million pieces of face mask totaling to 54 million pesos.
I'd like to ask the Money Laundering Council to inspect all the bank transactions that may have occurred with this company so we will know the money trail. There's so much billions of pesos that have occurred here, and we don't even have a money trail where this money came from.
Envision the need to infuse a lot of capitalization. During the pandemic, I think what really determined the factor is the access to the supplies, access to tangible negotiations with suppliers so that we can get the supplies first.
But toward the latter part of the hearing, formerly officers finally revealed who helped them with funding.
I just wish to state on record that we did receive Mr. Michael Young's help with borrowed money from him to pay for this.
You borrowed money from Mr. Young. You're now saying categorically that you borrowed money from Mr. Michael Young.
The company, not personally. The company.
Of course, of course. I'll be very honest. Michael Young paid probably advanced and paid the stocks. The goods.
Michael Young, former advisor to President Rodrigo Duterte, initially insisted that he is not involved in Farmally's operations, but admitted introducing Farmally to suppliers from China.
Okay, Mr. Chairman, what Mr. Young said is that initially he doesn't know of the existence or the whereabouts or anything about Farmally Pharmaceutical. Later on, they did approach him for some assistance.
These prompted senators to move for a subsequent arrest warrant against Young and Farmally Director Lincoln Ong for supposedly evading questions of lawmakers. The committee likewise approved Senator Risa Ontiveros' motion to request the Bureau of Immigration to subpoena Farmally Chair Wang Chuyen's father, Hung Wenlie, who is wanted in Taiwan for fraud. The Hwang Patriarch met with President Duterte in Davao City in 2017. Meanwhile, Gordon called out President Duterte for allegedly protecting Farmally and those behind the government's procurement.
The president seems to protect his double voice is another observation, almost to the point of inciting to sedition and attacking COA, a constitutional body. I'm not surprised because I think bilang mayor, medyo nakikita ko yung habit na ilang lang naman mga mayor na pinoproteksyan yung kanilang mga tao. Kapuri-puri kung tama yung pagdepensa, pero kung nakikitang mali, dapat tinawagan na nila yan at sinabihan na nila.
The Davao boys Gordon was referring to include former Undersecretary Lloyd Christopher Lau, who headed the Procurement Service of Department of Budget and Management, or PSDBM. Next is now overall Deputy Ombudsman Warren Leong, who used to work with Lau in PSDBM, and Anderson Loh, who is said to be applying to at the Office of the Ombudsman. Gordon sees Lau, Leong, and Law as part of a so-called cabal who helped in then Davao Mayor Rodrigo Duterte's presidential campaign and later on landed as officials of the presidential management staff. Sherrie Ann Torres, ABS-CBN News.